Okay, welcome everyone. Waiting for a few more to join in. What's going on in your school, everyone? What are they teaching currently? Heat transfer in Koramangala. And in HSR, what is happening? HSR and the other places. Rishim, what is happening in NPS HSR? SHM. Oscillations. So you guys are doing oscillations. And you guys are done with thermodynamics? Or that is something which you, oh, that is done. Kinetic theory is also done in NPS HSR. Kinetic theory is not done. Okay. Fine. Still lesser number of people have joined. Oh, that is also done. NPS HSR is very fast in terms of completing the syllabus. So you have anything going on in your school currently or any major exam coming up? I've seen some messages were circulating in the group. So midterm, right? It's a board exam. Grade 11, you have a board exam? Are you sure? Acha, for PU it is. For PU it is. For state board, it is a board exam. Okay. Next week. And in NPS, when is the midterm going to start? In NPS, when is the midterm? Midterm over? Did I ask your marks? Have I asked? Okay, I already asked. All right. Anyways, so I think in the previous session, last class, it was very theoretical. Okay, we have covered many things. And I am sure you guys are not as comfortable with those concepts yet as you want it to be, right? So in today's session, what I plan to do is a series of problem practice. And these questions, I will take it school level, CET level, or at max NEET or mains level. There will not be any advanced level questions, okay? So I plan to finish them off. And how many of you have already done the assignment and submitted? Anyone has completed the assignment which was given? No one? Because of the exams? You did, okay. There was no submitting option in the Class Pro. Is it true, everyone? let me just check. I'll extend the date if that is so. What we can do is that I will anyway do a lot of questions with you today. So maybe you can use that in knowledge and complete the assignments. Oh, there is no submitting of, sorry about it. I'll immediately create it. I'll keep a due date of Sunday. Fine. Sunday is a due date. The assignment is already given to you. Fine. Now it will show on your this thing, on your login. Fine. So you can submit it before Sunday ends. Now you'll you'll be able to see it. Fine. All right. So today we'll be doing questions, but before doing the directly jumping onto the question, I'll just quickly summarize what all the small things that we should. I mean, I'm just trying to revise it for you, whatever we have done in the previous class before we get into the questions, right? So only theory related to the problems. This is what first law of thermodynamics, delta U plus W. Okay. This is the first law of thermodynamics. It is used for a system. Okay. You define a system, then you have to follow some sort of sign convention. If heat is supplied, it is positive or negative? Delta Q will be positive, negative. Everyone should participate, okay? Delta Q will be, even though it is a trivial thing, if you participate in the trivial things, then the difficult thing will also come out naturally, okay? Fine. Now, if work is done by the system, then W is positive or negative? Good. It is positive. Negative, it is in chemistry. Understood? In chemistry, the formula itself is different. In chemistry, delta U is equal to Q plus W. Okay? The formula is reversed because the sign convention is different. Otherwise, first law of thermodynamics is same for chemistry as well as for the physics. Anyways, but this is what we follow in physics. What is the reason we are following work done by the system as positive? Because our focus is work done, right? That is why we are studying this chapter. We are studying this chapter so that we know how to convert heat energy into work. So what do we want? We keep it positive. Work done, we find like this, integral of PdV for the fluids. Okay. And then if Cp and Cv are basically molar specific heat capacities of the gas at constant pressure process or constant volume process. Okay. So let's say you give heat in a constant pressure scenario, then you can write the heat given in the constant pressure process as NCP delta T. Okay. And if you see that during the process, temperature is changing and volume is constant, then it is a constant volume process. So then you have to write heat supplied at constant volume will be NCV delta T. Fine. So there can be infinitely many molar specific heats for the gas. Okay, as it depends upon the process. Okay, so remember this. Then what we have learned is that for isochoric process, we had learned the work done is zero. For isobaric process, the work done is P delta V. This can also be written as what? In terms of temperature, what you can write? Work done. Look at your notes. Good. N R delta T. Fine. Then you have the adiabatic. For adiabatic process, the work done is negative of change in the internal energy. What is the formula for the internal energy change? You remember that? The formula for change in internal energy is what? Change in kinetic energy. What is the formula for that? Change in internal energy. What it is? You have done it in chemistry also. And CV delta T. Okay. Even though you are using a specific heat at constant volume, but this formula is same for all the processes if you are finding the change in the internal energy, because the change in internal energy is the state function. Okay. And for adiabatic, even the work done comes out to be a state function, because work done is nothing but negative of the change in internal energy. Fine. So in adiabatic, of course, heat exchange from the surrounding is zero. Now, these are the work done. Apart from that, there are few process equations that connects one point of a process with the other point of the process. Fine. So for example, isochoric process, P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. This is, I guess, Charles' law, right? Then isobaric process, you have V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. Okay. I think I have missed one more process here, which is isothermal. Isothermal, what is the work done? You remember that? What it is? Isothermal work done. NRT natural log of V2 by V1. This is also equal to NRT natural log P1 by P2. All right. So this is Gay-Lussac law. This is the Charles law. And for the isothermal, we have Boyle's law. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Then for the adiabatic, what is the process equation, everyone? Remember, for adiabatic, what is the process equation, all of you? P1 V1 gamma is equal to P2 V2 gamma. All right. Then T1 V1, you remember this or not? Type in. What is gamma? What is gamma? Gamma is what? Cp by Cv, this is greater than 1. Because Cp minus Cv is equal to R, Mayer's relation. Okay, so you know, you just need to remember these few things. And anyway, when you solve numericals, you don't even have to make any efforts to remember all of this. You automatically tend to remember, just like I'm remembering it. Now, few things related to the graph also you should keep in your mind while solving numericals, okay? Let's say you have this pressure volume curve. You go like this from this point number one to point number two. The work done is the area under the curve. Now, looking at the process, can you find out whether the work done is positive or negative, whether the gas is doing work or work is done on the gas? How will you find out? In this process, work done is positive or negative when you go from 1 to 2? Correct. Work done is positive if the volume increases. It is very simple. The formula for work done is integral of PdV. dV is what? Change in the volume. So if change in the volume is negative, final is less than the initial, change is negative. So work done will also be negative that way. Okay. Then one last thing about the cyclic process. Because machines runs on the cyclic process. So when you learn the heat engines today, you'll see cycles. Is heat engine removed in your school? In HSR, have they covered heat engines? Did I already ask you that question? 1, 2, 3, 4. You did not know. Setu Manocha, Carnot engine is done in your school or not? No, but you are in Kormangla, right? You're in Kormangla. Who is from HSR? Okay. It is deleted. Carnot engine is deleted, but heat engine is done. Have you done refrigerators, heat engines, refrigerators? Okay, no. Actually, it is officially not deleted. Okay, so heat engines and refrigerators, if you go to the official site, cbsc.nic.in, it is there. And that is the reason why it is there in all the competitive exams you're going to write. So I'm not going to delete anything. We are going to learn everything. Okay. And you may not do it for your UTs, but then use it like a practice kind of thing. Okay. Because engine is no new concept is there in engine. Whatever you have learned, you're using it to understand engines. Okay. For example, this could be Carnot engine cycle. Whatever I have drawn, a cyclic process, one of the cyclic process can be Carnot engines. Okay. Okay. You do not know. Let me just show you. CBSC syllabus for grade 11th. Where is the official site? This is the official site. Okay. .nic.in. They are the official sites. No. Very physics. This is physics. Look at this. Heat engine, refrigerator. It's there or not? So I'm not showing you so that, I mean, my intention of showing is that you should understand that if you leave it, it will come and haunt you in the competitive exams. It is not deleted officially. Okay, anyways, if it is a cyclic process, what is work done? Work done is the area of what? Area of the loop. Okay. And you can also find the work done like this: work done in 1 to 2 plus in 2 to 3, then 3 to 4, then 4 to 1, like this. Okay. And what else? How will you find out work done is positive or negative, everyone? Total work done in the cycle, is it positive or negative? How will you find out? Correct. If loop is in quadrant one, all PV graphs are in quadrant one only. Pressure cannot be negative, volume cannot be negative. So the clockwise is positive, the clockwise cycle. This is like a thumb rule if you remember. Anti-clockwise, negative. Okay, the logic is that the process which is happening at the top of the cycle, it will have the largest area under the process. So the top process will dominate overall. If top process work done is positive, net net will be positive only. So it comes out to be that if it is clockwise, volume will increase on the top side. So you can't go like this if work done is positive. But anyways, you can remember these thumb rules. And for the cyclic process, change in internal energy is what? Delta U is what? For one full cycle. Zero, you came back to the same point. All right. So if you use first law of thermodynamics for entire cycle, then delta Q, which is net heat that has gone in, net heat that has come out, which will be equal to W because delta U is zero. All right. So this is the summary of the last session we had. Let us see some of the questions. We'll take the basic ones only because I know we are just learning something completely new. And you have not done the assignment also. Do this. So some of you know, good. I don't want to announce it. Siddharth is saying something. So work done in A to B is what? Everyone, what kind of process A to B is? Isochoric. So isochoric, the volume is constant, so work done will be zero. Kitna simple hai, right? So simple. Work done in A to B is zero because the volume is constant. And what is the process B to C? What kind of process it is? Isothermal, constant temperature. What is the formula for the constant temperature process? Work done. NR, temperature of that process, T2, log of final volume by initial volume. This is what it is. Okay. Now, can you guess what is this C to A process? Assuming, actually, it is not very clear. Assuming that this line goes through the origin like this. Okay. Imagine the line get x. This is a straight line only. It's not. What process it is? C to A. Correct. Shaduli got it. Others? Isobaric. What is the reason? Slope of line is what? Volume divided by temperature. It's a constant. And when that happens, what is the isobaric process? Okay. So work done in C to A is P times V1 minus V2. Right? So going from C. Why did you say going through the origin? It is going through the origin. It is not given in the question, but I'm telling you it is. They should have mentioned it. So work done is P times final volume, which is volume at A minus initial volume, that is the volume at C. Okay? If it doesn't go through the origin, then it can't be isobaric. Okay? But then that's a very good question, by the way. Okay. Can there be a straight line in this volume temperature graph which will not pass through the origin? Is it possible to have some temperature at zero volume? No, why as in C? It is not mentioned in the question, okay? I'm telling you, assume it. It is an incomplete one, okay? So pressure into final volume minus initial volume, all right? Now the volume is given, but pressure is not given. So I am going to use NR T1 minus T2 over here. N is equal to 1. So R times T1 minus T2, okay? So this is actually the one of the questions which I had given in the assignments. And in the assignment, this is the answer what they have given, assuming it is isobaric process. All right. So that is why I know what is the answer, and it can't be that if it is not isobaric. Understood, Shadli? This. Do this one. Siddharth knows the answer, huh? Others? Okay, great. So, total work done is equal to what? Work done in A to B plus work done in B to C. Okay. Now, which part the work done is negative? A to B it is negative or B to C it is negative? Or both are positive only. A to B negative, right? So, this is area under A to B. It's a trapezium. So, negative of the area under A to B. So, that is half of sum of the parallel side 2P naught plus P naught into V naught. Then, B to C work done is positive. So, area under that you have to take half of this distance between them, 2V naught. Okay, so half P naught V naught minus 3 plus 10. This will be 7 by 2 P naught V naught. So option C. All right, so this is, yes, I'm sharing my screen. All of you can see my screen? Yeah, Siddharth, what happened? Siddharth is looking somewhere else. Don't open the browser, okay? Okay. No problem. Over here, this one. For this, we'll have poll, don't answer. After 2 minutes, we'll have a poll. Okay, just type in that you're done. Nobody's typing done. Done? Hint? No hint, nothing. Hint will be given after the poll is done. Okay, so the poll is coming. Shaduli wants to see the poll. Take the poll. Siddharth, are you able to see the poll currently? Okay, once the poll is gone, probably then the screen will come. All right, so I'm ending the poll. Oh, you don't know the option. Ending it. This is what you guys have selected. Fine. Majority. There is no majority actually, full of confusion. But between A and D is what? The correct answer is D, D for Delhi. Okay. Let us see how to solve. Some issue with your laptop, maybe Siddharth, not sure. Which laptop are you using? MacBook or some Windows laptop? Tab. Oh. Tab, you have to again and again zoom out the tabs, then select the tab which you are this thing. Which tab? The iPad? Samsung? I don't know how to. Okay, so between initial and final, INF. What is that one thing which is same between the initial and final points? Pressure is same, okay. Other than pressure, see, it appears that pressure is same. Need not be. Getting it? It is not written. It's not written that exactly it is same. It might happen that from initial, the pressure goes something like this. It's slightly different, the FS. So there is no guarantee pressure is same. Forget about that. But what is the guaranteed thing which is same between the two points? Same. Correct. Change in the internal energy, delta U. Do you all agree? For both the cases, delta U will be NCV, temperature at final minus temperature at initial. It does not matter what process it is. Do you all understand this? Type in. Okay, delta U is same. Work done is more where? Work done is more in A or B? Whose work done is more? Both are positive only. Work done in A is more because area under A is more. All right. So delta Q of A is delta U plus work done in A. So WA is more. So that makes QA more. Right. Delta QB is delta same delta U, but a lesser work done. So naturally, delta QA is more than delta QB. Is it clear to everyone why this D option is correct? Fine. All right. Let us move forward. Okay, some theoretical questions. School level stuff. Tell me. A, B, C, D. Conservation of work. What is that? No, you already got negative marking. Once you pick an option, Okay, fine, no problem. It is conservation of energy. I think I have told it so many times that I don't need to even discuss it. Find out. Everyone should answer. Okay, so heat is supplied. So delta Q is positive. And as per the first law of thermodynamics, this is delta U plus W. What is delta U for isothermal? Delta U is what? If temperature doesn't change, delta U is what? D0. Okay. Temperature is constant. And CV delta T is delta U, right? Delta T is 0. So delta U is also 0. Delta Q is equal to W and both are greater than 0. So work is done by the system. The gas will do the positive work. Clear to all of you? Fine. So such kind of theoretical questions are asked in, a lot of theoretical questions are asked in the NEET exam and in JEE Main also, at least 20 to 30% questions are theoretical in nature. This is the kind of question they ask. Okay, this one I have to draw the graph for you. So this is the volume, this is the temperature, this temperature is T1, this is T2, this volume is V1. This is V2. Okay, do it. This line, if you extend, will pass through the origin. It'll go through the origin. But arrow you want, arrow is actually not required, but then let us assume this is the arrow, the path. You can name the process. This is A, this is B, this is C. Done, all of you? Everyone tried? Type in. Have you tried? All right, let us do it now. We'll take pressure on the y-axis and the volume on the horizontal axis. Okay. So A to B is what process? What is A to B? Tell me, what is the process A to B, everyone? Correct. Isobaric, right? Pressure is same. All right. How can I say pressure is same? Because the slope of this line is V by T and that is constant. This happens for the isobaric process only. All right. So it is an isobaric process, A to B, and the volume of B is more than volume of A. So I'll just draw a horizontal line over there. This is a horizontal line I have drawn in the middle of this. So I'm saying this is point A, that is point B. So I have to go from A to B, right? The arrow is from A to B. Now, A to B, B to C is what? B to C is constant. B to C is isochoric, right? Everyone agree? B to C is isochoric. Type in. You can see that it is a horizontal line, so volume is constant. Okay, so B to C is an isochoric process. Yes. B to C. Now C to A is what? What kind of process C to A is? All of you, C to A is what kind of process? Isothermal, you have seen, it is a curve. So between A and C, you have to connect a curve. Like this. Okay, so this is how you do it. And look at this. In volume temperature plot, it is an anti-clockwise cycle. In pressure volume, it becomes clockwise cycle. Okay, so there is no rule as such that if it is anti-clockwise, it will remain anti-clockwise in volume temperature graph also and so on. Okay, nothing like that. Why the curve have to be bulging out? It is like this only. Isothermal curves are like that only. This is the kind of isothermal curves will be. It is a rectangular parabola, right? Pressure into volume is constant for isothermal. This will do at the end, leave it. We'll come back. CP and CV values are given. Part one, Shaduli got something. Others? Answer for the part one. Yeah, Shaduni get in terms of P0, V0, right? How are you getting a number over there? Is P0, V0 given? Well, they are not given, right? No. Siddharth got something. Shalini got something. Work done by the gas will be positive or negative in this case? Clockwise cycle positive. It will be area of this loop. Loop happens to be a right angle triangle. That is the best part. Half base into height. Half of base it. Base is what? This length, which is V0. 2V0 minus V0. This is the altitude. 3P0 minus P0. 2P0. The answer is P0, V0. This is for the A. Fine. Do it for the B. Heat rejected in C to A. Where is A, B, C? This is A. And this is C. In C2A, it is an isobaric process. So N Cp delta T, Cp is given 5R by 2. Use that. All right, so let's do it. Delta Q is equal to N Cp. Delta T, temperature at A minus temperature at C. Okay. Since it is heat rejected, it should come out to be negative. And it will, because TA is less than TC. Okay. Then N is equal to 1. Cp is what? 5R by 2 into Ta minus Tc. Fine. Then at point C, P0 into 2V0 is equal to NRTC. N is equal to 1. So I'll keep it that way. So TC is equal to 2 P naught V naught by R at A. P naught V naught is equal to RTA. So temperature at A is equal to P naught V naught by R. So TC and TA are this. So when you substitute it over there, you are going to get delta Q as minus of 5 by 2 P naught V naught. So you can ignore minus because they are anyway saying it is rejected. So the answer is 5 by 2 P naught V naught. Okay. Now get the answer for the C. Very similar. Tell me what is the answer. Adiabatic? No, it is not adiabatic. Who said? A to B is not adiabatic. Okay. Isobaric? A to B is isobaric? A to C? Yeah, it is isobaric. Correct. A to B is isochoric here. So delta Q would be equal to NCV temperature at B minus temperature at A. Okay. So N is equal to 1. This is 3R by 2. Temperature at B is 3 P naught V naught by R. Temperature at A is P naught V naught by R. Can use ideal gas equation at B and A. Fine. Those who are using shortcuts will get it completely wrong. So the answer is 3 P naught V naught. Follow all the steps. Okay. This is what you'll get. Till now, everything is clear. This question has multiple parts, but each part is, if you look at just one part, you can say it is a school level question. Fine. So there are like four questions in a single question. Now find out for the D, D for Delhi. Last one. Which process is B2C? Can you tell me? What is the process B2C? Temperature is constant. Why? No. Why you say temperature is constant? What is the process B2C? Everybody? It is not any standard process. Okay? It's not any of those standard processes which you have learned. It is some process which you have not named. So now do the D part. You can still find out. Find out. How you get it? How you get that? Yeah, both. You added B's and C's. Okay, then is that it? No, you created some rule in your head. Doesn't make sense. Total work done, then do. What do? What? Total work done is PV, okay? Then what? Okay. So, all right, Setu will speak. He wants to speak. Ah, Setu, how to do it?
Sir, can you hear me?
Yes, everybody can hear you.
Sir, so total heat is equal to delta Q total is equal to delta Q total, which is zero, plus total work done, which is P naught V naught. And delta Q total will be QCA plus QAB plus QBC.
Correct. That is how you did. Good. And one of them will be negative. If heat is given to the system, it is positive. If it is released, it is negative. So what Setu said, absolutely correct. For entire cycle, delta Q, when you write delta U plus W, for full cycle, delta U is zero. So delta Q A to B, delta Q B to C plus delta Q C to A is equal to total work done, which is P naught V naught, which you have already found out. Okay. So you can't use any formula for B to C because it is not a standard process. So that is how you are doing it. But C to A and A to B are standard processes. So this is minus 5 by 2, that is 3. So minus 5 by 2 P naught V naught plus 3 P naught V naught plus delta Q of which process? B to C. B to C is equal to P naught V naught. This is how you get the answer. 2 P naught V naught minus 2 P naught V naught plus 5 by 2 P naught V naught. So that is half of this. Okay. Anyone has any doubts? The last part of the question was, you can say it is good. The other parts were just direct formula substitution. Type in, is this clear to everyone? Got it? Okay. So shall we do slightly difficult one? One difficult question. All these type of questions you have done till now will take care of your school, take care of your CET, NEET, JEE Main in by some extent. But let us take slightly tricky one. Do you all agree? Shall we take or should we keep on solving like this only? We'll come back to these kind of questions after this one. Do you all agree? No one is answering. Only one person is. Should we take a difficult one? Slightly difficult, not very difficult. Not very difficult. I mean, I was anyway going to take that. But then don't consider it look to be advanced level. This is not advanced level. Okay. This is a derivation from your textbook, which in your school they have deleted. Can you guess what it is? This is a Carnot cycle, which we are studying. Very important. I don't want to skip it. Pressure and volume. We are treating it like a numerical. Okay. So there are two isotherms, isothermal plots. Let me first completely draw it, okay? Then you can draw it. Now you can draw. This is A, B. B to C. C to D. And D to D. Okay. Over here, you can say P1, V1, P2, V2. P3, V3, P4, V4. Okay. So A to B is given isothermal process at a temperature of T1. B to C is adiabatic process. C to D is again isothermal. At temperature T2, and D to A is adiabatic. Okay. Now, let's say P1, V1, P2, V2, P3, V3, P4, V4, everything is given to you, let's say. Everything. Okay. I want to find out the by the way, in B2C process, how much heat will be absorbed by the gas in B2C? 0. D2A also 0. Okay. So A to B, heat is absorbed or released? Can you tell me? It's an isothermal process. In A to B, heat is absorbed or released? A to B. Shardul is saying 0. Why? Area under A to B is the work done in A to B. This is positive work done or not? Work done is positive. Delta U is 0. So delta Q is also positive. delta Q is equal to work done for isothermal. Okay, so heat is absorbed. Heat comes in from here. This is the cycle that runs inside your car or bike. Broadly, you can say this is the cycle that runs in which A to B, what happens in A to B process, the fuel is burning. So the gas is absorbing heat from the fuel. All right. Now in C to D, heat is released. Q out. Okay. There is no heat absorbed or released from any other point or any other process. So I want you to simply find out Q in value, Q out value, W value in of the cycle. These three things. Find out. You can use T1, T2, V1, V2, anything. Done. I mean, direct formula you have to use here. Q in for A to B. Q in is equal to delta U plus W in A to B, right? Delta U is zero. Temperature is constant and it is an adiabatic process. So NR T1 log of V2 by V1. This is a heat that is going in. Okay. Then C to D. Heat that goes out. This is equal to what? With the same logic, it is equal to the work done in C to D. Fine. That is equal to NR T2 natural log of V4 minus V3. Remember, this is a negative quantity, okay? This is negative. V4 is less than V3. Okay? Now, work done is what? Heat absorbed. If you use the cyclic process and first law of thermodynamics into it, delta Q is equal to delta U plus W for the entire cycle. Delta Q is heat absorbed in A to B plus B to C plus C to D, D to A. Delta U is zero, it's a cyclic process, that is equal to total work done. Okay. So I know that B to C adiabatic, D to A adiabatic, right? So the total work done is simply sum of these two, which is NR T1 log of V2 by V1 plus NR T2 log of V4 by V3. Till now it is clear to all of you. We have got Q1, Q in, Q out and W. Okay. Will there be a negative sign? It is already a negative quantity. This is a negative quantity. If you want to put a minus there, first take a mod of this. When you take a mod, you become V3 by V4. Are you getting it? This is the work done. This is Q in. Now, if you have to find the efficiency of this cycle, efficiency, we have seen in the previous class that it is equal to the total work done divided by heat that has gone in. Right? Total work done is NR T1 log of, what was that? Log of V2 by V1 plus NR T2 log of V4 by V3. Divided by heat that is given. Heat given is this only. Okay. NR T1 log of V2 by V1. All right. So the efficiency can be equal to 1 plus T2 by T1 log of V4 by V3 divided by log of V2 by V1. I'll put a minus here. T2 by T1 log of V3 by V4. I've reversed whatever is inside the log in the numerator. This. Is it understood till now? ask if you have any doubts. Ask if you have any doubts. Last step, see, V4 by V3, I have reversed. Log of X is negative of log 1 by X. You know this or not? Is it clear, Setu? All right. Now, what you can do is, look at this graph here. So B2C is what? B2C is adiabatic process. Okay, temperature of this point is T1 and that point is T2. Right? So since B2C is adiabatic process, I can say that T1 V1 gamma minus 1, T1 V2 at point B, volume is V2. This is equal to T2 V3 to the power gamma minus 1. B2C is adiabatic process. So I can use a process equation. All right. Similarly, I can say that D2A is an adiabatic process. So I can say that at point A, temperature is T1, V1, gamma minus 1. This is equal to T2, V4, gamma minus 1. All right. And if you divide these two equations, you're going to get V2 by V1 is equal to V3 by V4. Is this clear? This one is clear. What are last two step which I have written? Everyone type in. It was a very important derivation in your textbook. It got deleted. All right. Deleted in your school, not from your syllabus actually. And it would have been better if it would have been there. Then you know what will happen? If there is an exam from this chapter, only this will come, nothing else. So the earlier times it used to be like this only. So if there is a school exam and thermodynamics chapter comes, they ask only Carnot cycle efficiency derivation, nothing else. Anyways. So V2 by V1 is equal to V3 by V4. So that is why I can cancel out this and that and say that efficiency is 1 minus T2 by T1. Let's see, we have done so much circus. At the end, we are getting such a simple expression. Okay, this one. this is the efficiency, 1 minus T2 by T1. Okay. And this is the Carnot cycles efficiency derivation. This is the maximum possible efficiency a heat engine can have between the two temperatures. Maximum possible efficiency. All right. The higher temperature is T1, that is the flame temperature. When the fuel is burning, it is that temperature. T2 is, you can say, is the exhaust temperature. Roughly, it is the temperature of the atmosphere only. Okay. So if you need to have an engine between the atmospheric temperature and the temperature of the fuel when it is burning, the maximum possible efficiency will be 1 minus T2 by T1. You cannot devise any heat engine, any engine, it can never have efficiency more than this between the two temperature. Okay, so that is the importance of the Carnot cycle. Fine. All right. So since talking about the those whose focus is only schools, we are done with the school curriculum. Okay, everything we are done. Now we are going to learn about heat engines and refrigerators properly. Okay, because it is very much part of all the exams that you're going to write later on. So let us talk about the heat engines. I have a lot of other numericals that I will do once the theory gets over. Fine. So let us cover up the theory of heat engines and refrigerators. It will not take much of time. Probably before the break, we are done with entire theory. And then again, we'll take up the numericals. We'll be taking the simple numericals now after the theory. Write down heat engines. The sole intention of learning the chapter, other than getting the marks in the school exam, the sole intention is to learn how to create work from the heat energy. Okay. So if you do not learn how engines work, which is actually converting heat energy into work, then this chapter is useless. Fine. So we must learn basics of, how the machines work when it comes to converting heat energy into the work. Fine. So all the heat engines, they follow cyclic process. That is like given thing. It will be a cyclic process. Fine. Then all the heat engines will consist of a working substance. Working substance is nothing but, for example, in our car engines, the working substance is air plus fuel mixture. Let's say petrol engine is there. So petrol is a fuel, and with fuel, you need to inject air also. You need to inject oxygen, otherwise it will not burn. So the mixture, they're calling it as working substance. Fine. Write down the next point. The next point is the working substance absorbs heat at some higher temperature high temperature is nothing but the flame temperature. When this air and fuel burn, chemical reaction happens and temperature goes up. So it absorbs the heat due to that chemical reaction. And it releases heat at some lower temperature. Lower temperature is the atmospheric temperature. So every heat engine will have an exhaust to reject the this thing, heat. All right. Third, it will have a hot reservoir. Reservoir is just a name. We are saying reservoir because we are saying that it is a reservoir because we are assuming that you can absorb as much heat as possible without changing the temperature of the reservoir. That is why, without changing the temperature of the source, that is why source is called reservoir. You can, it is like huge, you know, you can keep on absorbing heat, temperature will remain constant. So to keep the temperature constant, you need to continuously burn the fuel, right? That is how the temperature remains constant. A hot reservoir T1 from which heat is absorbed. Okay. It needs to have a cold reservoir T2. From which heat is released. Fine. Okay. Fifth point. Fifth point is working fluid does the work. And it gets transferred to other components. It gets transferred to the other components, as in wheels will get rotated and so on and so forth, right? Let me just show you something. This is a diesel engine. I'll show the petrol engine.
My job is to make college easier because students have a lot of fun.
All of you, can you hear the sound also? Okay. So I'll keep on pausing and explaining to you.
Do the words auto mechanics make you curious? Actually, it's a cinch. A car is made up of wheels, seats, fuzzy dice, a body, and an engine. The internal combustion engine. The engine works in four stages. First, a valve opens and the piston lowers, letting a mixture of fuel and air.
So, I don't know why it is so animated, This valve is open, so the air and fuel comes in from here. All right, this is what it is saying.
Air into the combustion chamber. Second, as it comes up, the piston comes up.
Piston is closed. Sorry, not piston. The valve is closed. And this piston is moving up. As this piston is moving up, the pressure over here is increasing. This valve is closed, so the air cannot escape now. Fine. And now, blast will happen, as in some chemical reaction will happen.
This is the fuel air mixture. Third, a spark from the spark plug ignites the mixture, which pushes the piston.
So now the chemical reaction happens. Pressure suddenly increases because of the combustion, and this piston is pushed down. And after the burning has happened, the fuel is gone because it has burned, so that has to go out. So this is where the exhaust go out. Okay, let me complete it now.
Piston down again.
Let us hear it from the start.
Wheels, seats, fuzzy dice, a body, and an engine. The internal combustion engine. The engine works in four stages. First, a valve opens and the piston lowers, letting a mixture of fuel and air into the combustion chamber. Second, as it comes up, the piston compresses the fuel-air mixture. Third, a spark from the spark plug ignites the mixture, which pushes the piston down again. Fourth, the exhaust valve opens, and as it comes up, the piston pushes the spent gases out. And the cycle starts over again. Intake, compression, combustion, exhaust, intake, compression, combustion, exhaust, intake, compression, combustion, exhaust, intake. The movement of the engine is transmitted to the wheels for the driver's delight.
So I hope you have understood how everything works. All right. So this is how all the cars right now are running. All right. Not just cars, all the automobiles, everything. So for any cycle, if it is a cyclic process, I can say that delta Q is equal to this, delta U is zero, is the work done. So Q in minus Q out, this is equal to the work done. All right, and for heat engines, what is there in the heat engine? It absorbs heat at the higher temperature, as in it is an isothermal process. It absorbs heat, okay, from the higher temperature and releases heat at the lower temperature. So both absorption of heat and release of heat, they are isothermal processes, okay? And you are not allowed to absorb or release heat from any other process. Okay, so in order to complete the cycle, let me show you. You need to absorb at a higher temperature, release at a lower temperature. You cannot absorb or release from anywhere else. So in order to complete the cycle, you need to connect to adiabatic processes. That is what Carnot cycle does. Okay, you're clear now? Fine. So there is a block diagram. You can show it by using some sort of block. This is a popular way of representing that at a higher temperature T1, you absorb heat. You're absorbing heat Q1 and you are releasing heat Q2 at a temperature T2. This is a working fluid. The fluid does the work. This is how you represent it. A better representation, actually. Okay. We have already found out that the efficiency is equal to work done divided by heat that is supplied. Work done is Q in minus Q out divided by this is the efficiency. So efficiency is 1 minus Q2 by Q1, which we have already derived is equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. Okay. This is like the max possible efficiency. Carnot cycle efficiency is this. T1 and T2 in Kelvin. Okay. Fine. So this is the heat engine. Okay. Should not have been deleted. But then anyways, it is deleted. So delete it. Next, we are going to learn how refrigerator works, right? So if you are interested in learning in detail, like you want to construct the heat engine, all right, that you can do if you take automobile engineering or mechanical engineering in your as your major later on. Right now, it is just theoretical stuff. Next is refrigeration cycle, how refrigerators work. When I say refrigeration cycle, same thing is happening in the air conditioner also. Okay, so in a refrigeration cycle, what happens is, what is the basic function of the refrigerator? What do you want to do with the refrigerator? You want to maintain the colder temperature. Okay, how can you maintain a cold temperature of a system? Tell me. Inside the refrigerator, how you maintain the lower temperature? Broadly, what should be the process? If you do not maintain the temperature inside, then maintain the temperature somehow inside, it will go up. Why the temperature inside the refrigerator goes up when you switch it off? Tell me. Why temperature goes up? Suppose you already cool, let's say refrigerator is already cold. Okay, you have maintained the coldness. Now you switch it off. Okay, it is perfectly isolated from outside. Then why temperature still inside the refrigerator will go up? Why? Because when you put something, let's say vegetable or anything inside the system, what will happen is that there might be some staling process happens that releases heat. Okay. That is one very obvious thing. Other one could be that, let's say refrigerator is already cold. Now you are putting something hotter inside it. That will also release heat. Okay. So you need to constantly take heat out from the enclosure of the refrigerator. And also, nothing is perfectly insulated. There, you might have maintained a very good insulation, but still heat from the surrounding may go inside the refrigerator. All right. So what happens in the refrigerator is that it takes heat away. It takes heat away at a lower temperature or at a higher temperature. There are two temperatures in which refrigeration cycle works. So you take heat out at a lower temperature or at a higher temperature. At a lower temperature. Good. So refrigerator takes heat from lower temperature and releases heat at a higher temperature. Okay, this is what it does. All right, and the work is done on the system. System doesn't do the work. So the gas doesn't do work. Work is done on the gas. Have you seen compressor in a refrigerator? Behind the refrigerator, the older refrigerators had a black box sort of thing. Have you seen it behind the refrigerator when you were a kid? I'll show you. Have you seen something like this in your refrigerator? This. Nowadays, they cover everything up. So you have entire covered refrigerator, is it? You don't see anything behind. Okay. So in case your refrigerator stops working for some reason, just try to break it open. You will see this black object over here. You know what it is? Any guesses what it is? It is written here. It's a compressor. It is a compressor. So work has to be done on the system, right? When work is done by the system, it expands. And when you are doing work on the system should get compressed. The volume should decrease. In order to decrease the volume, you need a compressor to compress it. And that is why you need electricity. Electricity, 99% of the electricity will be consumed by the compressor. Other than that, there'll be some lights you fit in inside the refrigerator and other, maybe pump and other things. But the majority of the electricity is consumed by the compressor to do the work on the system. All right. So the cycle is like this. It is exactly reverse of the heat engine. What heat engine does? In a heat engine, look at this. Heat is absorbed from a hot reservoir and is released to the cold reservoir. That is a heat engine. In refrigerator, heat is absorbed from the lower temperature and released at a higher temperature. Okay. So if you draw the refrigeration cycle, This is T1, that is T2. It is reverse, exactly. And the work is done on the system, W. Q1, Q2. Got it? And here also, we can use first law of thermodynamics. It's a cyclic process, all right? So Q in minus Q out should be equal to minus W. This W is going into the system. System is not doing the work, so minus of it. Q in minus Q out. So Q1 minus Q2. Let me name this as Q2 only, because in Carnot cycle also we have name. For T2, Q2, for T1, we'll have Q1. So Q2 minus Q1 is equal to minus W, or Q2 plus W is equal to Q1. Anyways, now tell me how you will define efficiency for the refrigerator. Any guesses? For engine, it was work done divided by heat that is given. For this, what it is? Work done, I mean, what do you want from the refrigerator? You want work to be done? What you want divided by what you give is the efficiency, right? What you want divided by what you give. So what do you want out of the refrigerator? Cold. Out of these three things, Q1, Q2, and W, what do you want? Refrigerator, what is the main thing? W? No. Don't tell me in words. Tell me which one of these three, Q1, Q2, or W, what do you want from the refrigerator? From the heat engine, it was W. For the refrigerator, what is it? The output is what? It should be Q2. You want heat to be absorbed from the cold place, right? So Q2. And what do you give? What is given? What is given? Q2 is taken out from this temperature. What you give? You give W. Okay. So we call it coefficient of performance. We don't call it efficiency for the refrigerator. The reason is it is more than 100%. Efficiency cannot be more than 100%. That is Q2 divided by W is what? Q1 minus Q2. This can be written as 1 divided by okay. Is it clear to all of you? Coefficient of performance. This is okay. So little bit of theory is still there. So right now we will take a break, and after the break we will continue. Little bit of theory is left, and then the remaining numericals. All right. All right. Fine. So let us continue from where we left off. This is a refrigeration cycle or heat pump that we have discussed just now. Now, did you learn about the second law of thermodynamics in school? That is also deleted. Everyone. NPHHSR, second law of thermodynamics. Have you done it? Rishim, second law of thermodynamics was done in your school or not? Okay, it was done. Fine, so let us talk about the second law of thermodynamics. So if there is one law that you have to say that is the most sacrosanct laws of entire maths, physics, chemistry, bio put together, that would be second law of thermodynamics. Okay. So it is a law which is so fundamental that if you find, you can find exceptions to almost every law, but if you find exception to second law of thermodynamics, you are wrong. Fine. So that is just an exaggeration of the same point that it's, I can say that this is a law that comes directly from the nature's or God's book. Fine. So I'll just talk about one example and make you understand what is this law about. So for example, let's say there is this block, okay, which is lying on the floor. Fine. So why doesn't this block jump on its own? Why it does not jump on its own and move up? You'll say, okay, energy will be increased. So energy is required. So I'm saying, why don't this block absorbs energy from the surrounding? Let's say if I supply heat from the down, let's say I'm burning something. So it is getting energy. So that energy, can it automatically convert into work and jump off? The answer is no. It can never happen. Okay. But energy conservation is correct. I mean, energy conservation is holding good here. You can supply energy which is equal to the gain in the potential energy, then also it will not convert and jump on its own. Second example, when you have a hot cup of coffee or tea or a milk, which whatever you prefer. The spontaneous process is that it will cool off on its own. Okay. But when it cools off, it cannot become hot again by absorbing heat from the surrounding from by itself. It cannot become hot again. All right. So basically, second law of thermodynamics tells you in which direction any process will happen. Okay. Conservation of energy or the first law of thermodynamics will tell you that if process happens, then delta Q will be equal to W plus delta U. But second law of thermodynamics will tell you whether it will happen from point number one to point number two or two to one. Okay. So basically it gives us direction in which things happen. Actually, second law of thermodynamics is so fundamental that it is difficult to put it in words and explain. Okay, so there are various examples and explanation to it, but there is no statement as such. So this is basically what that God or nature wants things in disorder. Okay, so disorderness is what is a natural thing to happen. Fine. For example, if you just leave a room for many years and come back, the room will be in disoriented conditions. Fine. It will never happen that you can't expect that a room which is disoriented will become ordered by on its own. Fine. So randomness is preferred. In fact, it is so fundamental that it explains why, you know, you age and why we take birth. All right. Basically, the randomness which is preferred by the nature or the universe, the physical quantity of randomness is entropy, basically. Okay. Entropy is nothing but degree of randomness. Just like temperature is degree of hotness, entropy is degree of randomness. Have you heard of name entropy? Anyone? Right? So how do you measure randomness? You can't measure it. You can devise some scale. For example, it's like you're asking me how to measure a temperature. Okay. So you can devise a scale just like temperature scale is measured. Okay. So here, degree of randomness has to increase in every, this degree of randomness or the disorderedness has to increase in every isolated system. If from outside, let's say there is no influence, let's say that there's a room, you leave it for very long, when you come back, it'll be disordered. But if you ask someone to take care of the room, so you'll make it in order after every few days, so it will be in ordered manner. So I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about a spontaneous process that happens on its own in an isolated system. Okay. So if you consider, let's say, if you consider yourself as an isolated system. Okay. So you as a, I mean, we as a human body, we have atoms, molecule, tissues, and all those things. Okay. So initially everything was very organized, as in we, when it was like a cell kind of thing. Okay, then multiple cells created. So disorderedness increases. All right. Then organs grew. So more and more, as you age, disorderedness increases. Wrinkles will come up. Okay. And you'll grow older. And that is how the death happens. Okay. So even you can explain, I mean, you will not see people aging backwards, right? You will not grow younger. You'll always grow older, because that is as per the second law of thermodynamics. Fine. So, I mean, there's a saying that as per the second law of thermodynamics, the only purpose the human has is to come, increase the entropy of the universe and die. Okay. If let's say the because of our existence, if universe's entropy cannot increase, then we would not have existed. Our existence is to increase the entropy of the universe, to create pollution, to create the randomness in the overall scenario. I mean, that may sound funny, but then this is how it is. Okay. So it is a natural process. For every natural or spontaneous process, for an isolated system, should be in such a manner that randomness entropy increases in the system. So you can say that there need not be isolated system. Okay. There will be someone who can come and arrange things. But then if you include entire universe as a system, then nothing is outside the universe. So entire universe is definitely an isolated system. So whatever happens inside universe, the entropy of the universe must increase. If you are doing a process, okay, you may say that it is not a spontaneous process. You are doing it. All right. But if you consider entire universe, whether you do it, someone else do it, you're inside the system, whatever you do for the universe, it is a spontaneous process. Okay. Let's say this mobile phone, one atom is doing something inside this mobile phone on its own. That atom will say, no, it is not isolated. I am doing it. But what I will say, it is inside this mobile phone. It is happening on its own. If one atom is reacting from the other atom, I'll say it is a spontaneous process. Atom can't say, no, I am doing it. It is not spontaneous. Okay. Similarly, what do you do? You may be exercising in the gym. You might be burning some fuel. You might be running across, whatever you do. It is a spontaneous process for the universe. And it will happen only when entropy of the universe increases. Fine. So this is actually, I have not given any statement as such, because it is very difficult to bound the second law of thermodynamics with words. All right. So what various scientists they did, they have tried creating their own statements as per their understanding. Fine. So there are second law of thermodynamics statement from the Kelvin Planck, second law of thermodynamics statement from the Clausius. Okay. There are many other statements are there, but these two statements are mentioned in your NCERT. So let us quickly talk about it, and then the theory of the chapter gets over. I think in chemistry, there's a formula for the entropy also. In physics, there is nothing like that. Write down Kelvin Planck statement. No process is possible whose sole result is to absorb heat from the reservoir and convert it entirely into work. It will never happen that you can convert the entire energy into work. Heat energy I'm talking about. Some energy will be released to the universe as a tax to increase the entropy. Okay, so this is how it is. You can never convert 10 joules of heat energy into 10 joules of work. This is what, this is as per the second law of thermodynamics. Okay. Second statement is Clausius. Write down, no process is possible whose sole result is to absorb heat from the cold reservoir and transfer it to a hot reservoir. It can't happen spontaneously that you take heat from the cold and transfer it to the hot reservoir. Fine. So if you find out some of the there are a lot of documentaries on second law of thermodynamics and many interesting things are there. So I will send one link also in case you have some free time. Do watch those documentaries. There are many interesting stories behind second law of thermodynamics. Fine. So this is what this entire chapter is all about. Now we can solve the remaining numericals. And by the way, do you have any doubts, anyone? Can you tell some documentaries? Documentaries I'll forward on the group itself. No doubts? All right. Let us solve the remaining questions. Do this. in heat engine for piston to move up to increase pressure, how is the energy supplied? Inertia. It is due to inertia. Okay. Once the wheel start rotating, it will rotate quarter circle, then remaining part it will rotate on its own. Okay. Done, anyone? Sharduli got it, Siddharth got it. Work done by the gas in B2C. It is a positive work done or a negative work done? Everyone. Positive or negative? It's negative, right, Sharduli? Look at this, volume is decreasing or not? Right, so it cannot be positive. All right, so let us do this question. We have a cyclic process ABCA. 2 moles of ideal gas, a total of this much joule is withdrawn from a sample. A to B is what process? Which process A to B is? All of you agree it is isobaric? Right? Okay. Work done by the gas during the process B to C. And A to C is isochoric. So what is given is this much heat is withdrawn. Total heat withdrawn is that much. So Q out minus Q in. Well, let us do it like this. Total heat withdrawn in a cycle. What it is? Plus 1200 should I write or minus 1200 here for a cycle? It is given as minus 1200. Okay. And this is equal to W or not? For entire cycle, right? That is W. So W is work done in A to B plus work done in B to C. Fine. Plus work done in C to A. This is equal to delta Q, which is minus 1200. Fine. So C to A, the work done is zero. All right. A to B is isobaric process. For isobaric process, the work done is P delta V. Properly do it in one or two steps, you'll get the answer. There is nothing in this chapter other than first law of thermodynamics to use. Every time you have to use first law of thermodynamics only. Now here delta, the volume information is not given. Temperature is given. So instead of P delta V, what should I write here? Because temperature I know. What I can write? Correct. NR delta T. Now, you know that A to B volume is increasing. So work done has to be positive. So it will come out to be positive only. But if you know beforehand that it has to be a positive quantity, you'll feel more confident about it. So 1200 minus N is 2, R is 8.3. I hope you know that the value of R in SI unit is 8.3. Final temperature 500. Minus 300. How much you're getting this? Anybody done like this? Anybody did like this? No one? 3 into 2, 200. Minus 4520 joules. Okay. But I was thrown out of the meeting because of the internet issue. My voice is clear. I'm using mobile phone network now. The Wi-Fi has some issue now. Okay, I'll keep my video off because it is the mobile phone network. may feel some lag. Right, so heat is withdrawn from the gas. All right, so it means gas is releasing heat. Is it clear? Shaddad, is it clear now? Let's move forward. These are not difficult questions, fine? You must be comfortable with this. You might be not very comfortable right now because you haven't done practice, right? So a little bit of practice, you'll be comfortable. Do this. Sharply got something. Others? CC is cubic centimeter. Cubic centimeter cube. SI unit is meter cube. Anyone? Got something? No one got the correct answer. I'll do it now. K Pascal. K is tennis for 3. This is 50 into 10 to the power 3 Pascal. Oh, sorry. I have to switch off my video. Now my voice is not breaking, right? Setu? Setu doesn't want to see me. Setu, are you able to hear me? Still it is breaking. For everyone, my voice is breaking. All right, I am back. With a better internet connection. If somebody now says that my voice is breaking, look at the speed. Okay, so my voice should not break. All right, so let us solve this. We have, you're going from A to B through ACB and then through ADB. All right, whether you go from ACB or ADB, what is that something which will remain same? Delta U will be same. Delta U is same. Okay. So for ACB process, all right. For ACB process, delta Q will be equal to delta U plus W1, let's say. This is delta Q1. 50 calorie of heat is supplied. All right. So 50 calories, how many joules? 50 into 4.2. This is equal to delta U plus W1. This is your first equation. Okay. Then you need to find delta Q2. This is equal to delta U, which is same over here also, plus this W1 is what? W1 is area A1, which is this area. Okay. The other area is this blue one. Okay. Let us name these two areas A1 and A2. So when you go from ADB, the work done is A1 plus A2. All of you agree? The sum of two areas. How do I get 4.2? अरे 1 calorie is how many joules? Setu, 1 calorie is how many joules? You have to convert this in SI units, right? You're using SI units. So I am interested in finding delta Q2. Is this clear to everyone? The way I have written here. Fine. Now I'll subtract. So 50 into 4.2 minus delta Q2. Why I'm subtracting? Because wait, this is A2, right? Lower area for ACB. This is for ACB, lower area. Why I'm subtracting? Because delta U is not given to us. When you subtract, it will be gone. This is equal to minus of A1. Now, delta Q2 would be equal to 50 into 4.2 plus A1. A1 is the area of that rectangle, which will be equal to 155 minus 50 into 10 raised to the power 3. This is that length multiplied by this, which is 400 minus 200. 200 cubic centimeter, 10 is power minus 6. All right, this is A1, which you can substitute here and you get the value of delta Q2. Is this clear how you get the final answer? Should I tell you the final answer? The final answer is 231 joules. Okay. Are you finding these questions difficult? Let me ask you that. Let me take a poll. Are these questions, forget about that Carnot engine derivation, this question, let's say this question, is this question difficult? Yes or no? This question only, is it difficult? All right, ending the poll now. So this is what I have. Some of you are still finding this kind of question difficult. So what do you do? You know, I can give you very simple questions that will make you very happy. And I know how to make you happy, right? I'll just give you so simple question, you will be like, oh, I am able to solve everything. You'll feel good about yourself. But then when the exam comes, whether you write CET level or JMAIN or NEET, whatever level you write, these kind of questions will come. You'll not be able to solve them. So it is better to do these kind of questions, okay, so that you understand what you can expect later on. No point doing the simple ones. Okay, what is 1 plus 2? What is 3 minus 4? Okay, that kind of stuff, those days are gone. All right. So just follow the schedule, do your assignments, okay, and pay attention in the class. It's very easy. Like I can give you so simple question, everybody can get the answer, but that will not help anyone. Isn't it? Do this. temperature of the gas at point B is what? Tell me the value. Tell me the value of temperature at point B. Answer you tell me. That is wrong. Tell me the value. Shaduli got it. I know what kind of silly error you guys will be making. Okay, that is why I asked the values. All right, so let us see. And you'll get -1 because you have made a basic mistake here of not converting Celsius into Kelvin. And I know that this is a trap. Okay, so the people who are setting the question paper, they know you better than you know yourself. Just like what I know, that kind of silly error you will make. That is why I was asking, tell me the value. You're telling 2 times of TA, right? This is equal to VB by TB. So TB is equal to VB divided by VA. By T into TA. Okay. So VP by VA is this 2 times TA. Now there is a trap here. Convert temperature into Kelvin. It is 300 Kelvin. So this is how much? 600 Kelvin. In degree Celsius, what is the temperature? 600 minus 273. Okay. So this is 327 degrees Celsius. Few of you were telling 56 degrees Celsius because you multiplied 27 by 2. Anyways, do the B part. What we'll do is that B part, one by one, we'll find out. First, tell me heat absorbed in A to B. What it is? Assume CV to be 3R by 2 and CP 5R by 2 by 2. Setu got it. Others? The unit should be joules, right? Time. More. As you want 30 seconds. should I like not give you the assignment and tell you to complete the previous assignment only, and I'll shift the due date? Will you all do that do the previous assignment then completely? Okay. All right, let us try that. Those, I'll do that. The previous assignment, since not many of you have done it, do it. I'll not send the solutions of those. Do that only. Let me change the due date of that assignment. That is your next week's assignment also. Where it is? This one. So I'll put it as 10th. But don't wait till 10th. Okay, complete it quickly. You have anyway some exams coming up, right? All right, so QAB, it is what? Isobaric process, all of you agree? V by T is a constant, it's an isobaric process. So it will be N Cp delta T. This is 2, Cp is 5R by 2 delta T. Delta T is Tb minus Ta, which is 600 minus TA, 300. This is the answer. All right. 1500 times R. Anybody got this answer? Setu got it. Good. Then B to C. What is the heat absorbed in B2C? Shardili, again and again, isothermal process, I think you're telling third time that heat absorb is zero. In adiabatic heat absorb is zero. Why are you telling isothermal heat absorb is zero every time? So that got something. Okay. Heat absorbed in B to C. It's an isothermal process. Delta U is zero. So whatever heat is absorbed is equal to the work done. All right. So this is equal to NR temperature at B log of VT by VB. Now VT by VB is not known, or is it known? Yes, you can divide this equation from that one. All right. Delta U is zero because delta T is zero. It's an isothermal process. 2R TB is 600 log of 2. Because if you divide this with that, you'll get VD by VB as 2. That is 1200 R natural log 2. Anybody got this? Okay. So this third part is the homework. Try doing it yourself. Let me see if I have something new. Just do the first part. That is enough for today. CV is 3R by 2. CP is 5R by 2. That's given. Actually, if you learn kinetic theory of gas, just because it is given, it is monoatomic. So it is understood CP and CV values are this. Do you know the formula for the work done? Adiabatic process. Correct. No. Minus N CV delta T. Minus. So what is not given to you is temperature at D. Everything else is given. So the question boils down to finding the temperature at B. Just tell me the value of temperature at B, what it is. The problem is solved then. Say two got some temperature and that is not correct. Others, say to check for the silly errors. Little time, 1 minute given. Okay, now let us do it quickly. So what all things are given to us? Pressure at A is given, pressure at B is given, temperature at A is given, temperature at B you have to find out. So what we have is PV raised to power gamma is a constant. Okay, P1V1 gamma is equal to P2V2 gamma. I want the relation between pressure and temperature. Okay, then I can easily get it. So I know that PV is equal to nRT. So V is equal to nRT by V. This is a constant. So V is equal to nRT by P. So T to the power gamma divided by P to the power gamma minus 1. So this is equal to T to the power gamma divided by P2 to the power gamma minus 1. All right. So T2, which is TB, is equal to P1 by P2 gamma minus 1 divided by gamma times T1. Okay, so this is how you get the value of T2. So I'll tell you the final answer for the T2. T2 is where it is. Hold on. 850 Kelvin is what you'll get, T2. Okay, not a problem. Even though you got a wrong answer, way better than not doing anything. So do the assignment. Trust me, if you do the assignment immediately, like today, tomorrow, and day after, in these 3 days, if you complete the assignment, you will have to never study this chapter till grade 12 gets over. Okay, so these simple chapters, you have to be a little aggressive like this. All right, so that's it from my side. We will meet next week and see whether we have to do SHM or kinetic theory by then. Okay, bye for now.